Y'all please bow y'all's head and pray with me. Dear Lord, we come to you this evening with happy yet heavy hearts. We are thankful for the years and memories we have shared together, but we are sad as coming to an end. Please be with us all as we continue our journeys in life and go our separate ways. Lord, be with us through every step in our lives and help us remember to always put you first. We would like to thank you for placing our family, friends, and school staff in our lives. Without them, we wouldn't be here today. In your heavenly name I pray, dear Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Well, I guess we've almost made it. This coming Friday, we're going to walk across the stage, receive our diplomas, and begin preparing for our future. And it wasn't without all of your guidance and support that we can say we are where we are today. But soon we're going to take our next giant leap into adulthood. And James 1:12 says, "Blessed is the man who perseveres under trial, because when he has stood the test, he will receive the crown of life that God has promised to those who love him." This ceremony is to celebrate what we have achieved and reflect upon who we have been, because we know there is change coming. So, on behalf of the Seminole County graduating class of 2015, we would like to welcome you to this year's baccalaureate service. We hope that you will join us in the celebration of the camaraderie of the past, thrill of the present, and anticipation of the future.
How do I say goodbye to what we had? The good times that made us laugh are waving back. I thought we'd get to see forever, but forever is gone away. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday.
Mr. Kent Richardson, or Coach Kent, as some of us call him, has served as Seminole County Middle High School assistant principal for the past 8 years. During this time, he has served as head middle school coach and assistant softball coach for the Seminole County Lady Indians. He was married to his high school sweetheart, Tammy, for 35 years and has two children, Garrett and Joanna. Personally, Mr. Kent has been a great inspiration to me. I could always count on him to be there whenever I needed him to go for a problem or on the field. He inspired me and encouraged me in everything I did. So, Mr. Kent.
Y'all, it's already going to be emotional. This is the first time I've talked to a group since Tammy has passed away. So pray for me. But I wanted to talk to you about different things. I asked Mr. Tony to help me out, and we got a short video of some things that will hopefully help you as you graduate and go through life. I know that at times you have wondered if you'd be able to do all the things required of you to graduate, especially changing the curriculum throughout your high school career. You have accepted and passed all these expectations required of you to graduate. Seminole County school system has provided you with great educational opportunities. You have had teachers which have loved you and helped you along the way. Now is the tough test. Now you must face life. You'll be on your own. You'll be in strange situations. Mom and Dad won't be there with you. But one person will. And I'm going to talk about that at the end. While my children were growing up, we were fortunate to be in a place called Swamp Gravy. And it was finally proclaimed to be Georgia's official folk life play. And during this time, one of my good friends wrote a song for the play, and Joanna was fortunate enough, I think she was maybe 5 or 6 at the time, to sing a verse of this song. And I asked Mr. Tony if he would get some of his singers to come sing for us today. Pay attention to the words, because if you're old as I am, when you were growing up, your parents told you some of these same things. And graduates, I'm sure that as you were growing up, your family members told you the same thing. So pay attention to the words. It's just a short little verse, and I know you're going to enjoy it. It's hard to believe that just a few short years ago, you were in their places, elementary school. Now you are graduates. I knew that with me getting up here and just talking to you, you probably wouldn't remember a lot of what I said, but when you get these young ones up here like this, you're going to remember what they sang about. Two of the main things is they don't give up on jobs until you get through with them, and you've done that. I'm sure throughout your career as being in school that there's many times you just wanted to say, this is it, I've had it, I'm tired of this homework, I'm tired of doing this, but you persevered and you made your way through it. Another thing that they said, choose good friends, and you have done that. You know who to hang with, you have something right here that tells you who you need to be around, who you don't need to be around, and I'm proud to say, I am proud of each and every one of y'all. Now, this is going to be another, they say that a picture's worth 1,000 words, well this video is probably going to be worth 1,000,000. It goes to the heart of what a true friend does for you. So we'll run that video right quick.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine, thanks. How are you?
Good, nice to meet you. What's the act called?
Charlotte and Jonathan.
Charlotte and Jonathan. Okay. How old are you both?
I'm 16.
I'm 17.
Okay. And you thought the combination would work. Whose idea was it?
It was our singing teacher's, actually. She thought it'd be good to try us out together. And we both sounded quite good when we sang what we did.
Okay, you're not saying much, Jonathan. Are you shy?
Sometimes. I've always had sort of problems with my size since I can remember. And when I was in sort of primary school, it was back then really that I had sort of the mick taken out of me, and it kind of damaged my confidence quite a bit. When people would say something to me, it'd just take a little piece out of me in a sense.
I'm quite protective of Jonathan. Like, if I was there and someone stood there and said something to him, I couldn't sit there with my mouth shut. Before you make a judgment on someone, I think you really need to get to know them. It's not. As cliche as it's not judging a book by its cover, you've got to read what's inside.
Charlotte's been a really big help for me in terms of confidence and making me a better performer, and I really don't think I'd be going up on stage today if I didn't have Charlotte by my side.
And do you think you could win?
Yeah, together.
Yeah. All right, good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Here we go.
Like that, you sing beautifully together. It was world class.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
a pop voice and an opera voice together. It was incredible. Okay, this is what I think. As Charlotte, I think you're good, but Jonathan, you are unbelievable. You have an outstandingly good voice.
Thank you very much.
How old are you?
17.
I mean, that's unbelievable. Jonathan, you are a future star.
Thank you.
I like the fact that this works as a duo, but I worry, Charlotte, whether you're going to hold him back.
We've come on here as a duo, and we're going to stay here as a duo.
Okay, David, we better vote yes or no. Oh, such an easy decision. Yes.
Thank you.
Definitely a yes from me.
Charlotte, I think your voice complements Jonathan's really well, so don't be disheartened. It's a yes for me.
You know, my head here would say to you, Jonathan, dump her. And then my heart would say there was something kind of magical at moments together as well. So I'm going to say yes to the two of you. You've got 4 years.
Yes! Well done!
Well done, Paul.
He's like a young Pavarotti, that boy.
Yeah.
I haven't heard a voice like that in years.
To be that young and that good.
Simon's a massive fan of you, isn't he?
Seems like it, yeah.
That is the biggest response we've had today.
Well,
oh my God.
Oh, hold up, my pal.
You think it could be life-changing?
Life-changing? Well, yeah, to be honest.
I think for you.
Yeah.
So you see, if Charlotte hadn't been there for him, he wouldn't perform one. And you heard him say at the end that because of her, it's going to be a life-changing experience for him. And that's what you need. You need friends. You can't get through this life without your loved ones and your friends. Now, the most important part. That's to get you through life. But there's other places we're going when life is over. This story is about a little boy that lives in Chicago. And he was homeless. And he was trying to make a living by himself, selling newspapers. Well, this particular night, a blizzard was coming in. And he walked up to the policeman there on the corner and said, did he know of a place that I could go and spend the night? Because I'm living in a box up around the corner, and I know it's going to be mighty cold tonight. The policeman told him, said, go down this street, go up to this house, and knock on the door. And when they open the door, just say John 3:16. Well, the boy followed the policeman's directions. He didn't know what was going to happen, but he was trusting the policeman that he was not going to lead him astray. So he walked up to the house, knocked on the door, and a lady came to the door, and he said, John 3:16. That's all he told her, John 3:16. And she said, come in, son. So she took him in and set him down next to a great big fireplace and let him warm up for a little bit. He sat there for a little while and thought to himself, John 3:16, I don't understand it. But it sure makes a cold boy feel warm. Later she came back and asked him had he had anything to eat. He said, well, I really hadn't had anything to eat for a couple of days and I could use a little bite. So she took him into the kitchen and had a table just full of anything he wanted to eat, and he sat there and he ate until he was full. And again, he said, John 3:16, I don't understand it, but it sure makes a hungry boy full. She took him upstairs to a bedroom, to a bathtub that was filled with warm, soapy water. He got in the tub, and he sat there, and he soaked for a while. And as he soaked, he thought to himself again, John 3:16, I sure don't understand it, but it sure makes a dirty boy clean. You know, I've never had a bath before. I always play in front of the fire hydrants when the firemen are cleaning the plugs. The lady came in and got him, took him to a room, tucked him into a big old feather bed, and pulled the covers up around his neck and kissed him goodnight and turned out the lights. As he lay in the darkness, he looked out the window and saw the snow falling. He said, John 3:16, I don't understand it, but it sure makes a tired boy rested. The next morning, the lady came back up and got him, took him downstairs to that same kitchen, which was still full of food. And after he ate, she took him back to the same big old rocking chair in front of the fireplace. She took a big old Bible, sat down in front of him, and she looked at him and she said, do you understand John 3:16? He said, no, ma'am, I don't. The first time I ever heard it was last night when the policeman told me to use it. She opened the Bible to John 3:16, and she began to explain to him about Jesus. Right there in front of the big old fireplace, he gave his heart and life to Jesus. He sat there and thought, John 3:16, I don't understand it, but it makes a lost boy feel safe. And you know, I don't understand it either. How could God send his son to earth to die for me? How could Jesus even accept this, you know? He could have said, no, I don't want to do that, but he didn't. He loved us all enough that he was willing to give his life for us. I don't understand it either, but it sure makes life worth living. John 3:16, for God so loved the world, that's us, that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Senior class of 2015, may God bless you always.
With dreams, and faith gives you the courage. courage to dare to do great things. I'm here for you, whatever this life brings. So let my love give you roots and help you find your wings. It's not living if you don't reach for the sky. I'll have tears as you take off, but I'll cheer as you fly. I pray that God would fill your heart with dreams, and faith gives you the courage to dare to do great things. I'm here for you, whatever this life brings. So let my love give you roots and help you find your wings.
This town, I keep thinking that it's not goodbye. I keep on thinking. It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again, when I see you.
We flew, good things we've been through. Then I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. See you in a better place. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything
everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I see you again.
We've come a long way,
yeah, we came a long way
from where we began.
You know, we started.
Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I'll tell you.
When I see you again.
You both go out your way and the vibe is feeling stronger. What's small turn to a friendship turn to a bond, and that bond will never be broken, the love will never get lost. And when brotherhood come first, then the line will never be crossed. Established it on our own when that line had to be drawn, and that line is what we reach, so remember me when I'm gone. Can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
So let the light guide your way. Yeah. Hold every memory as you go. And every road you take will always lead you. It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
On times we had, I hope you smile and know that through the good and through the bad, I was on your side when nobody could hold us down. We claimed the brightest star and we came so far and no.
Now rough ahead, and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed. You just remember what your old past said, or you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Now some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by, a friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
I've had the privilege to know the next speaker for quite some time now. He has greatly influenced my life, and I know that I can and have gone to him multiple times throughout my life for advice and guidance. He has been the pastor at Lakesville Baptist Church for the past 5 years now, but he has also played a greater role in my life as my dad. I would like to introduce Mike Heath.
Ken, I think I'm the one that's going to get emotional here. Who would think that you would have your daughter introducing you at a baccalaureate? Y'all look good, guys. Look good. You know, I'm going to date myself, but I'm going to do this for an illustration, so bear with me for a moment. Next month, 36 years since I sat in your seat. Now, I know you're thinking, dude, you're old. You'd probably be right. But it goes by that quick. Let me illustrate further. When I sat where you're sitting, I used to think, God, is it ever going to be your will for me to marry somebody? Years went by, and then suddenly she came. 28 years have come and gone since we've been together. 3 children. My youngest or my oldest. I used to walk around holding him on my arm while we lived in Germany, and I'd do chores in the house while he would be on my arm. He thought that was the coolest thing. Now he's married, and he's living in Alaska. It goes by fast. You blink, and it's gone. Can I get an amen from those of you sitting in the back? I tell you all of that to tell you this. Make some good choices. Revel in the moment. Live in this moment. Enjoy this moment. Because when you blink, it's going to be gone. Now, 2 years ago, I didn't need these. So you're probably right. I am getting a little bit older. But I want to share with you a couple of things. Ken, it sounds like God has us on the same page. I thought, this is Rachel's day, and it's your day, and I thought, what could I share with you that might have some level of significance? So I wanted to share with you 3 things, and I hope it means something to you. The first thing I want to tell you is that God loves you. Do you understand the gravity of that statement? God loves you. Now, you may be sitting there thinking, well, I've been told this, I know this, but let me share with you a couple of ways in which God has gone to such great extent to show you that he loves you. He knew that Adam and Eve were going to make some bad choices in the garden, and he knew he had to have something in place when that moment came. It came. Nearly 2,000 years ago, he loved us so much that he sent his son. His son's name is Jesus Christ. And Jesus came. God said, go. Jesus came. God said, die. And he did. You see, Jesus loves you so much that he got on something called a cross, and he took your sin and he took my sin and he put it upon himself so that you and I wouldn't have to die the death he died, even though we deserve to die that death for our sin. He loved you so much that he was willing to die for you. And some of you sitting here today don't have a relationship with him. But he loved you so much that on the third day after he died, God resurrected him from the dead. Because see, for us in Christian life, we do not serve a dead man. We serve a risen Lord. Our God loves you so much. Not only did he raise his son on the third day, 40 days after he raised him from the dead, he raised him into heaven. Our God loves you more than you can ever understand. Some of these pictures, that's framing material. I would recommend you hold that and use that and go back and look at it later in your life. Today, you are here because God orchestrated your life to put you in this moment, in this time, in this place. Now, the question for you is, what are you going to do with it? More than anything else, God wants a relationship with you. Let that sink in for a second. The God who created you wants a relationship with you. He wants to walk with you, and he wants to talk with you. He wants to be there for you when you cry, and he wants to be there for you when you walk and live. He wants to tell you this. In spite of what our society tells you, there is a heaven and there is a hell. God loves you so much that he says in his Bible that he doesn't want any one of you to go to hell. But if you die and do not have a relationship with the living God, that is where you will go. Now let me just tell you quickly what hell is like. The Bible says that in hell you burn. Your body is consumed with flames, and yet you cannot put them out. You're in pain. You're in agony. And you hurt. The Bible says that you're swimming in a lake of fire, and it goes on to tell us that is complete and total darkness. God doesn't want any one of you to be there. That's why Jesus came. That's why he offers you salvation. That's why he loves you so much. He wants you to know the truth. Don't listen to our culture. Our culture will tell you everyone is going to heaven. Our culture is lying. Only those who choose to have a relationship with Jesus Christ will go to heaven. I'm not preaching. I'm simply sharing the truth. God loves you. God also has the answers. I'm looking at some of you, and if you were like me, I had no clue what I was going to do when I walked the aisle and got my diploma. I had signed a contract to go into the Army, and that was the only thing I knew, was that I was going into the Army after I graduated. I didn't know anything else beyond that. Do you have the answers to the questions of life? Do you have answers to the biggest questions that plague us all? Questions like this. Who am I? Why am I here? Where am I going? How am I going to get there? God has the answers, and God will gladly give you that information. All you need do is ask him. He loves you so much. He does not want you to be alone. He does not want you not to have the answers. You see, some of you sitting here today have a God-sized vacuum in your lives. We all have it. Nothing seems to satisfy you. Do you know what I'm saying? You just seem to be in a barren place. There's no peace. You can't seem to do anything to find satisfaction. That is what I call a God-sized vacuum. God created you to have relationship with him, and nothing else will satisfy it. Sex won't do it. Alcohol won't do it. Relationships won't do it. Drugs won't do it. Going to college won't do it. The only thing that will fill that void and give you purpose and identity and a goal and a true focus is a relationship with Jesus Christ. God loves you. He has the answers, and God wants to take care of you. There's an old Christian song that goes something like this. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him, there is no other. Jesus is the way. I hope you'll think about those words because they are really true. I'm here to tell you as one who has walked with God for a large portion of his life, he is everything you need, and he's all you need. He will meet your biggest desires. He will quench your thirst. He will satisfy your hunger. He will give you what no one else can. And if you'll trust him, he will take you to places in life you could never, ever get to on your own. You see, God wants to help you, but what I love about God is God will never force himself upon you. If you don't choose to walk with God, as much as he loves you, he will let you make that choice, but he will not force himself upon you. Many in our country today will tell you that you are our nation's future leaders. I beg to differ. You are our nation's leaders. What you choose matters. And if you don't have a relationship with God, that, ladies and gentlemen, is the biggest choice you will ever make in your entire lives. Because everything outside that doesn't matter. Moms, dads, you will join me on Friday night at 7:30 at Seminole County High School Auditorium. And there we will sit together, ladies and gentlemen, one by one. The class of 2015 will be called. Brinson Register will call your name, and Mr. Bonner will stand there with a green jacket with nothing inside. And he's going to give that to you as you walk the stage. In that moment, moms and dads, some of them crying, some of them with jubilation, some of them, all of them, will be sitting with my wife and I in the bleachers, and we will stand quietly while you walk the stage. In that moment, we are launching you symbolically into life. Like a bowman who has an arrow and he strikes it on his bow and he pulls it back and he launches you. From that point forward, you will go and live in a world that I will never see. You will interact with people that I will never meet. And the only Jesus they will see will be the Jesus that you show them. The only God they may possibly know will be the God you display through the way you live and what you say and do. What you choose matters. I hope, if you hear nothing else, you hear this. Choose a relationship with God. Choose a relationship with Jesus Christ. Choose to love him. Choose to follow him. Choose to obey him. And he'll change your life. He will show you how to live. And like was saying earlier, you will soar through life. Choose to live without him. And the world that you're about to go into will eat you alive. I want to thank you for letting me have the privilege to say a few words to you today. And just know that I will be praying for you. And I'm excited for the life that you're about to go into. 2015. Blink a few times. And you'll be sitting over there looking at your son or your daughter sitting here. And you'll be thinking, dude, I'm old. God bless you guys.
Will please stand with me. And if you'll remain standing after I pray for the alma mater, pray with me. Heavenly Father, I come to you today in all that this moment is finally here. I ask that you would bless all that we have heard today. And Lord, I pray that we would take something from it and that we would use it to glorify your name forever. Thank you so much for getting us this far, and I pray we would always allow you to take us to the greatest of heights, and Father, that we would always keep your commandments as you have taught us, and may we always just honor and glorify your name, and may we be a light to others. In your precious and holy name we pray, amen.
Class of 2015, please join in and sing our alma mater. If you don't know the words, they're in your program. To remind you all that everyone is invited to attend the reception immediately following the service in the fellowship hall in honor of our graduates. If you turned in pictures for the slideshow, please pick them up in the side room of the fellowship hall following the reception. And now I would like to introduce Reed Stark for the benediction.
I don't think they wanted me to give a speech, but they gave me a microphone, so. But we have a good-looking class here, and I'm proud to graduate with them. There's one thing I wanted to remind you is Philippians 4:13. Now, I grew up, and I knew Philippians 4:12 and 13. It says, I know how to abound, and I know how to be abased. Both everywhere and in all things, I am instructed both to be hungry and to suffer need. And I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Everywhere you go, have God with you, and you can get through anything. You can go anywhere. So, if everyone would please stand with me, we'll pray. Every head bowed and every eye closed. Father God, we come before you today to thank you for all that you've given us, for the way that you've brought us, and we pray that you guide us even further, Lord. Get us where we need to go. Have a safe hand over us in any career that we choose, from doctors to lawyers to teachers to even those in the military, Lord. We ask that you give us your hand. Guide us through any obstacle. Keep us through any trials or tribulation, Lord. No matter what, remind us who you are and that you are with us, Lord. We thank you for your son that you gave to die for us on the cross. We pray that you be with us, Lord. Touch every one of us in your name. Amen.